Let's now consider some examples of the trace distance. Let's say that we want to compute the trace distance between two states in the standard basis, namely between row 0 being 0 and row 1 being the 1 state. Now we already know, in fact you've calculated in the first homework, that there exists a measurement that distinguishes these two states, namely a measurement in the standard basis. If I measure in the standard basis, my measurement operators are m0, 0, 0 and m1 being 1. And you can see that the probability that I get the outcome 0 if the state was actually 0, meaning the trace of m0 row 0, is in fact 1. The same is true for the 1 state. Probability of getting outcome 1 if the state was 1 is also 1. You might want to check, but we already know that because probabilities should add up to 1. But for consistency, you should convince yourself that the probability to get measurement outcome 0 if the state was actually row 0, given by the following expression, is 0. So my probability to distinguish these two states, P distinguish, is 1/2 times trace of M0 with row 0 plus 1/2 times trace of m1 with row 1, which is equal to 1/2 times 1 plus 1/2 times 1, which gives me 1. So I can perfectly distinguish these two states. Let's see now what happens to the trace distance. You would expect the trace distance to be large because these states are easy to distinguish. Let me write down the definition of the trace distance. Trace distance between 0 and row 1 is equal to the maximum over measurement operators m, the trace of m, row 0 minus row 1. And if I write this out for our case, what I have is the maximum of a measurement operators m, which is equal, trace of m, 0 minus 1. So note that this measurement operator here is a positive operator. So the trace of m with 0 as well as the trace of m with 1 is always positive. So this means that if I look at this, note that this is just the same as maximum over m trace of m with 0 minus the trace of m with 1, that this here is larger than 0 and this here is larger than 0. So it's in my best interest to make sure that m has absolutely no overlap with the 1 state. Or in other words, that m is really just 0. And this is precisely the same as the measurement in the standard basis that we had chosen up here. So if I calculate this, this term here will vanish, will be 0, and this term here will be 1. So the total trace distance is equal to 1. This is as large as the trace distance could be, meaning we can perfectly distinguish these states, as expected. Let's now consider another example, where in fact we have not just one qubit, but many qubits. And I want to compute the trace distance between rho 0, which is 0 everywhere, and rho 1, which is 0 everywhere except on the very last qubit. Let's compute the trace distance. The trace distance between d0 and d1 equal to the maximum over measurement operators m, trace of m, rho 0 minus rho 1. So this is equal to the maximum over m trace of m with this one. And I will actually now write all of the n minus 1 zero states in front. Times 0, 0, minus 1, 1. So remember what we had done in the previous example. M is positive, so this means that M with any negative component can only hurt us when trying to perform this maximization. So we want, as before, that m has no overlap with the 1 state. So what I can do here is I can choose m to be equal to 0, 0, n minus 1, times the 0 component. So this ensures me overlap 1 with this part, and it ensures me overlap 0 with the 1 part. This is very similar to our previous example. So if we compute this, we see that the trace distance is equal to 1 from this part minus 0 from that part, so the trace distance is 1. This means that I can perfectly distinguish these two states. And it's also easy to understand why this is the case. I can ignore all the first n minus 1 qubits and just look at the last one. If the last qubit is 0, I have rho 0. If the last qubit is 1, I have rho 1. You can see that it's possible for a state to look very similar on many qubits, but if they look very different on only one of them, here the last one, then the trace distance can be large. Finally, let's consider another example where the states are not pure, but one of the states is a mixed state. Namely, I want to compute the trace distance between rho 0 being the maximally mixed state and rho 1 being the zero state. So again, I maximize over measurement operators, trace of m, rho 0 minus rho 1. So let me plug this in. I have the maximum over m, trace of m, the maximally mixed state, and note now that the identity is just 0 plus 1. So this allows me to expand the maximally mixed state is half times 0 plus half times 1. This is from the maximally mixed state, and here we have minus 0. So let me combine these terms. I have maximum of m, trace of m with half times the one part. So let me put the half out front. So here I have a half 0, here I have minus 0, so I have minus a half trace of m with the 0 component. So note that again, because m is a positive operator, both of these terms have to be positive. So the second term can only hurt me. It would be good for me to choose m to have no overlap with the 0 state and full overlap with the 1 state. Or in other words, I choose m to be equal to 1, 1. This ensures that the second term again vanishes and the first term becomes 1. So I have half times 1, which gives me a half. So you can see that even though the trace distance is now not 1, the trace distance is decently large. And I leave it to you to figure out what this means in terms of distinguishing the two states, row 0 and row 1.